Hello everyone, welcome to SemiCon Talk. Today's topic is Package Reliability Test. Let's talk about it. Package Reliability Test is to predict the lifetime of the package in real application environment without failure. It also can screen out package defects. It is commonly used to qualify package for production as well. The best way to check package reliability is to test in actual environment condition with real use time, but it takes too much time and money, means not practical. So, package reliability tests simulate this actual condition with much shorter time using statistics. And today, we'll talk about based on plastic package. Usually, there are two categories in package reliability test, short-term test and long-term test. Short-term test checks package integrity, means how robust it is. So, it checks delamination and interfaces and package crack. It uses MSL, moisture sensitivity level, for this. And sometimes, it is also called as MRT, moisture resistance test. Then, 3 times of leaf flow is followed. Long-term test checks package reliability and uses electrical open-shot test to make sure electrical integrity of the package. It consists of preconditioning and reliability tests such as TC, HAST, HTS, etc. So for short-term test, procedure is first electrical test, open shot, visual inspection, SAT, scanning acoustic tomography, bake. Second, MSL with 3-time leaf flow. Third, visual inspection, SAT, electrical test, open shot. For long-term test, procedure is first electrical test, open shot, visual inspection, SAT, bake. Second, preconditioning. Preconditioning is designed to simulate the failure conditions the package may have during boat mounting process, and it is done before reliability test. It looks similar with MSL, but MSL test is to determine the time span, flow life. The package can be exposed after opening moisture barrier bag and before boat mounting. Third, 3-time leaf flow. Fourth, reliability test. Fifth, visual inspection, SAT, and electrical open shot test again. This is one example of SAT image for the package and SAT machine. This is an example of leaf flow furnace for leaf flow process. Moisture sensitivity level test is to simulate boat mounting process and to identify the potential failure during this process. It is also called moisture resistance test, MRT. Typically, plastic packages absorb moisture during storage. Then moisture turns into vapor with volume expansion during leaf flow process at high temperature. Pressure from that volume expansion causes delamination, package crack, etc. Moisture sensitivity level test is based on JEDEC standard, and it provides device sensitivity to moisture-induced stress. So, it can expect flow life, which can determine the length of time a device can be exposed to humidity and temperature after opening moisture barrier bag and before boat mounting. Then, it is useful to determine proper storage and handling. There are many levels, and these are some popular examples. Level 1 is non-moisture sensitive. Its test condition is 85 degrees C with 85% relative humidity for 168 hours. If the package under test passes this condition, it means its flow life is unlimited when the package is exposed at lower than 30 degrees C with 85% relative humidity condition. Level 2 is limited moisture sensitive. Its test condition is 85 degrees C with 60% relative humidity for 168 hours. If the package under test passes this condition, its flow life is 1 year when it is exposed at lower than 30 degrees C with 60% relative humidity condition. Level 3 and 4 are moisture sensitive. Its test condition is 30 degrees C with 60% relative humidity for 192 hours and 96 hours. Level 6 is highly moisture sensitive. Its test condition is 30 degrees C with 60% relative humidity for 72 hours. We mentioned about 3-time leaf flow in previous slide, and here is the leaf flow profile. There are 4 steps by time. 1. Lamp to soak. 2. Preheat soak. 3. Leaf flow lamp up and peak. 4. Cooling. Here is one example for red pre-solder. Step 1. Lamp to soak. Soak minimum temperature is 150 degrees C. Step 2. Preheat soak. Soak maximum temperature is 200 degrees C. Soak time from minimum to maximum temperature is 60 to 120 seconds. Step 3. reflow, lamp up, and peak. Liquidus temperature for lead-free soldering is 217 degrees C typically. Lamp up rate from liquidus temperature to peak temperature is maximum 3 degrees C per second. Cool down rate from peak temperature to liquidus temperature is maximum 6 degrees C per second. And time between liquidus temperatures is from 60 to 150 seconds. Step 4, cooling. Temperature cycling test is to check package resistance to alternating low and high temperature in air. Coefficient of temperature expansion, CTE, is different for each material. For example, dye, mold compound, lead frame, or laminate substrate. So, there is CTE mismatch between these materials when the package is exposed to low temperature and high temperature alternatively. This CTE mismatch causes mechanical stress, then delamination or crack. Typically, 1,000 cycles are used for package qualification. Summer shock test is very similar to summer cycling, but it uses liquid instead of air. So, temperature change is more rapid, and mechanical stress by CTE mismatch is more severe because of rapid temperature change. So, summer shock is more severe test than temperature cycling, and 1,000 cycles are commonly used for this test. Temperature cycling test is more popular than summer shock test. Temperature humidity test is to check metal corrosion, particularly for dye surface metallization under temperature with moisture. Temperature and humidity are good enough for corrosion, but bias can be added, so-called THB. Then it can trigger or accelerate metal corrosion. The failure mechanisms are galvanic, electrochemical, direct chemical corrosion, and ion migration. Usually, 1,000 hours are used for package qualification. Highly accelerated temperature and humidity stress test, HAS, is an accelerated version of THB test. THB takes 1,000 hours, but HAS takes 96 hours to complete. High temperature storage test is to check the effect of long-term storage at elevated temperature. That effect includes oxidation and intermetallic growth. Usually, 1,000 hours are used for package qualification. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye-bye.